What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the Transcast. I'm Edwin.
I'm Cooper.
I'm Nadia.
And today we are here to react to Channel Orange by Frank Ocean. This is... whose pick is this? I forget.
Nadia's
pick. I guess before I give it off to Nadia, I'll just kind of like preface. Frank Ocean is my favorite artist of all time. Blonde is my favorite album of all time. So I thought that Nadia picking Channel Orange was such a great idea, and I am in full support of that because I've wanted to dip our toes into the Frank Ocean.
Wow! So, like, you tried that before.
Well, I fucked it up before we started recording, and now you don't have to tell them that though. But yeah, so we're starting with Channel Orange, and the goal is to eventually do everything: Endless, Blonde, Nostalgia Ultra, and then all, like, maybe even the singles that came out after Blonde. Like, there's like five or six little singles we could do in like one video. But anyway, Nadia, Channel Orange, why?
Well, he's also like either my favorite artist or like my second favorite artist. He's definitely up there for me. And obviously we wanted to start the Frank vids, and I was like, let's start with Channel Orange. Because I think we were talking about how, like, obviously Edwin and I have like listened to it through multiple times, but Cooper hasn't listened to it like all the way through as much, but has heard obviously the big tracks off this album. So I was like, let's do that, because we are all Frank people here. So yeah, we're just gonna like start that little saga, and yeah,
cool. I have to say, it has been a while since I've listened to Channel Orange like all the way through. Obviously, like, it's like in my bones, right? Like, I'm very familiar with it, but I haven't like sat down and really like listened to it and in its entirety for a while, so this should be interesting for me as well.
In my bones is so real. It's a good way to put it.
So yeah, Cooper, you have any thoughts before we jump into it, or anything you want to add?
There's probably going to be a lot of tracks where I'm like, oh, I know this song, because I feel like I have listened to everything.
And you're
on
also
here.
Friends with us.
Yeah, I've listened to I probably listened to everything on here, but never sitting down and listening to the entire album. So
okay, cool. So yeah, I guess we'll jump into it. It's 17 songs, 55 minutes, and the first song is called Start.
What's happening? I haven't heard this one before.
No shit, really?
Does that sound familiar to you?
No.
No? Really?
It's a whole new experience. Well, it's like 33 seconds.
Sound? No. I'm pretty sure it's the PlayStation 1 when you turn it on, I think.
Oh, well, I never had a PlayStation 1.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's why it's familiar, yeah.
All-time classic?
I know this song!
Okay, yeah. Yeah. A tornado flew around my room. Oh, Franklin.
Hey, we're one song in already.
It feels really weird reacting to him, though.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Like, this is my boy.
Thinking about you. Oh, sorry. Can't sing.
Yeah, don't sing.
Hard not to.
For every time he does that, it tickles my brain.
Yeah.
Like you, I just thought you were cool enough to kick it. Got a beach house I could sell you in Idaho. Since you think I don't love you, I just thought you were cute. That's why I kiss you. Got a fighter.
Best lyrics ever.
I was literally about to say that.
I can't.
This is maybe the highest he's sung in like any song. Like, consistently, I mean.
maybe his last screech in Ivy, though, is the highest he's ever gone.
This song is so singable, man.
I know, dude. It's so fucking singable. this part makes me fucking tingle.
I was just about to say, this verse kills me. Just captures what it's like to be in love, you know?
Yeah.
I don't.
This is such like a summer album.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Blonde is like the summer album though, to me.
This is a 10 p.m. windows down kind of song, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Have you not done that before with this song?
Yeah, everyone has.
Yeah, I mean, not much to say. We all know Thinking About You. It's like a fucking all-time classic prank song.
Yeah.
But just like that spatial, like the warbly, whatever it is. I guess it's like a synth or something, but it kind of like does this. I don't know how to like.
It's so sexy.
It's so fucking. Oh.
Like you're. It's like you're on waves.
Whoa!
Hey!
It's short, but catchy as fuck. Makes me want to do this.
It's so cute. I can't.
I haven't heard this one. You know what? I probably haven't heard a lot of this very short ones.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Oh my god, you know what this is like? This is like, you know, in there's a movie and it's a comedic scene where it's just like playing elevator music.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm curious if you've heard this, Coop.
I recognize the name, but I don't recognize the sound.
His voice is so fucking good, man. It's my favorite voice.
Agreed. We're behaving like
teenagers. I love the way he sings that, teenagers. Still inside our parents' home. No, I don't live in Denver.
I feel like you can always like visualize his music.
Yeah, for sure.
It's like so immersive.
Oh man, it's so sexual, you know what I mean?
This album does really have that tone.
Yeah.
Like, especially when you get to like pyramids and shit.
This guy's spitting right now. Oh. My daughter's reaching
for your nipple cause it's time for her to be. Fuck.
For real.
I want to sing so bad. I was going to say, for me, a lot of Frank's music, when I listen to it, I can always picture and visualize certain memories and times in my life, like places I was, what I was doing, what I was looking at. You know, just that whole 100%. Feel. Like, it just brings me back to, like, the past every time.
The best song wasn't the single. I know this one.
Oh, yeah?
You do? Good. Living in Ladera Heights, the Black Beverly Hills,
domesticated paradise, palm trees and pools. That bass, man. The water's blue, swallow the pill,
keeping it surreal. Whatever. It's such good driving music.
whatever feels good. Yeah.
I was literally just, I was transported back tonight, to being in the Beamer.
Mm-hmm. Just, well, that's very Frank Coding. Frank Coding BMWs. Frank Coding,
yeah. You're on the money with that one.
Okay, hold on. Here we go. Sweet life, sweet life. It's so like classy and upbeat and like joyful and like jazzy, I guess, too, like a little.
Yeah.
Totally.
It's almost like Frank Ocean songs feel like it could be a really good soundtrack for a movie.
No shit.
Can't seem to turn the signal fully off. Transmit the way. You're catching that breeze till you're dead in the grave. But you're keeping it so real.
Ooh, I really like the way he just sort of like,
yeah,
his voice grew in there.
Yeah.
And then you got like that backing, like those like oohs that come in. Yeah, sorry.
No, it's just he has a range, that's why.
Yeah.
Grapevines, mango, peaches, and lime, a sweet life.
Like, it's so summery.
Yeah.
It's so, like, just every visual.
Oh my god.
There's so much to the song that I know, but also don't know.
I feel like that's going to be a lot of this album, because it's been so long since you've really listened to it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's such a well-known album, so
yeah,
the sound's really familiar.
And that scream.
Oh. There's so much like soul behind it, too.
Yeah.
This song specifically.
I love this
so
shit.
So fucking funky.
This makes me want to go to a jazz club, man.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Is that a Beamer turn signal?
Yeah, probably, honestly. I don't know how you knew that.
It just sounds super familiar.
I'm bopping to the fucking turn signal right now.
Can you pause it for a sec?
Yep.
Can we pause? Okay. I normally don't like interrupting to share little personal anecdotes, but Super Rich Kids is obviously like one of like the biggest, if I guess one of the biggest songs on the album. Like, it's very well known. But
yeah.
I remember, Cooper, you'll like understand this. My first day of first year of university, I was shitting myself because I was so nervous, and I was like going to my first lecture and I'm like, I'm gonna cry, like I'm just nervous, I'm like not ready for this whole change. And then I got into the lecture hall and our professor was like setting up a music cue to like make everyone feel comfy, and this is the first song that came on, and I'm like, I'm gonna be okay. Like, they've got me. They put Frank on as the first song. It's going to be a good time. And I felt so comfy after that because I'm like, oh, these are my people, you know? But
I was vibing the first day. I wasn't nervous at all.
No, oh, you're so fucking cool. Gonna...
No, he cried. To the oh, you're so he had to air out his shit. But anyway.
Architecture was story. Like, you're going to fucking never see your friends or family again. And I was like, that's fine.
Yeah, and then mine was just a fucking vibe, and I was like so happy. But anyway, I just wanted to share that because music makes you, you know, comfy and shit. So,
all right, cool.
Yeah,
yeah, Super Rich Kids. This is out. Why? Before we start, this is one of my favorite Frank Ocean songs, like entirely. So yeah.
Hmm. Cool. Coop, you have to know this.
Oh one. Yeah, I know this one.
Too many bottles.
Yeah. Bottles of this wine we can't pronounce. Such a vibe, though. Of that green,
no lucky charms. Bro, your prop is a G for putting this on first.
Yeah, that's right? Cool as fuck.
I felt so like at home. Too many joy
rides in Daddy's Jaguar. Aesthetically, though, like this album is so pleasing for me. White
lines. It's super rich kids with nothing but loose
ends. Super rich kids with nothing but fake. Oh, that was one of the songs I had on my likes. So yeah,
oh, nice. Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
If you really listen, like there's really not much to this instrumental.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's very simple, but it's so fucking.
That's a thing. Sometimes less is more, depending on the vibe of the song.
It's his voice carries it. His melody does.
That's because his voice is a fucking instrument.
I love that line. No lucky charms. Parents ain't around enough. Song, it sounds very LA. You know what I mean? Like the theme of it.
Yeah. I'm picturing white sand.
Yeah. Really sunny palm trees.
When he said white lines.
Huh?
Is that what you pictured?
No.
Sorry. I'm searching for
a real love. Oh.
No, I meant that as like I picture a beach day.
Okay.
But like not white lines.
Sorry.
You guys ready for Earl's sweatshirt? You guys know anything about him?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Anyway.
I have listened to him a little. Can't imagine. We are the Zanny Nash and Caddy smashing bratty assy Maddie snatched his daddy's jag and used the shit for batting practice. Adam and Annie thrashing, purchasing crappy grams with half the hand of cash you handed. Panic and patch me up, Pappy done lashkied us. Do
you guys know anything about our future? Because like they were
yeah,
all
that's
together.
I mean that's how I know him.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Don't believe us, treat us like we can
erupt. Yeah. I like that. Yup. And then he just ends.
Yeah.
But when I'm drunk, I act a fool.
Talking about. Oh yeah. It's good times. Yeah. Sleep if
someone slip and fall. The mic is down like 60 stars. My boy is suffering in the best way. My
silver spoon. It's very good. Wine we can't pronounce. Too many bowls.
Such an
now we got some like
iconic like lyrics. Come around too
much. But now we get like somewhat of like a heavier bass, or I don't know what exactly it would be, but like we're getting some substance to the instrumental, and it's just like, oh, it's so smooth. And this album won a Grammy for Frank.
What did it win?
Like best urban contemporary or something like that, I think.
Mm.
Yeah,
that's what they called it.
I was surprised. They usually like giving awards to Taylor Swift.
Oh, the way it ends. Oh, so smooth.
Real
okay, bro, this is one of my faves from the album, actually.
I'm such a fucking idiot.
I fucking love the
what?
Vibe.
What?
I just realized why it's called Channel Orange and why there's so many like switching stations.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, like the aesthetic, the theme, yeah.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be like really analog and like, you know, retro kind of. Ready?
Oh, hello.
Guys.
I haven't listened. Shut up.
Yeah, shut the fuck up, Nadia.
You too, Edwin.
Y'all hearing this shit?
Yeah, it's great. Oh, fuck shit, man. Holy shit.
Yeah. Dude, it's one of the best, in my opinion.
This is my favorite so far.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that line. I'm so red, dude.
Let's fucking go.
I'm sweating.
The softness here.
I know.
Are you fucked? Come on, dog.
I feel like I'm floating.
Condom on a cloud.
Condo.
Condo, motherfucker.
That was the best one.
All right. I just want to say, bruh, before we get to the next song, the next three songs might be the best three songs on an album, like best three song album first run. It's up there for me, at least.
Agreed.
You better not fucking lie to me.
Dude.
One of my fave songs of all time is coming up.
Like, iconic, dude. At least for me, I don't know. Ah, the plant's going down! Ah! Alright, shut the fuck up. It's crack.
I haven't heard
time.
This.
Oh, you haven't? Okay, this is like not a fun song. No, it is fun, but the lyrics are really not fun.
Yeah.
Hey, we're having
energy.
Yeah. We're having fun, right, guys?
Yep.
You might want to put the lyrics up for this just so you understand.
Dude, I'm gonna have to read.
Yep.
Yes.
You don't know how little you matter until you're all alone. Yo. In the middle of Arkansas, with a little rock left in that glass dick.
Yeah.
Used to date a blonde.
Yep. Used to hit it hard. Yep.
She was and you are
madly involved, it's in stone. Glass homes, you're smoking stones in abandoned homes. It's in stones in glass homes, you're smoking stones in abandoned homes. It's in stones, broke your home. Who are
crack. I love how there's like the slight use of an organ in the back, eh?
Yeah.
That's not like too much.
Very subtle.
Shucking and jabbing. Shucking and jabbing. To get the fixing that you're itching for.
Your family stopped inviting you to thank. I hate this lyric. Won't let you hold the infant. That's so sad. Used to get a little kitchen stone. It's crazy that he can make a song about smoking crack and how it ruins your life sound so fucking beautiful.
Only him.
Yeah. And you broke your home. Crack rock. Crack rock, crack rock. Cricket cap that cap. Oh yeah, here we go. How much dope can you push to me? Cricket cap that cap. No good for community. Fucking pick your shots. 300 men will search for me. Don't no one hear the shouts. Ooh. Oh, that gunshot. Whoa.
Don't know and hear a sound. Don't know and disturb the peace for riot. Don't know and disrupt Nirvana. Don't know and wanna blow the high. Crack right.
Oh, fuck, man.
Crack rack. Ooh. Crack rack. How you feeling, girl? Ooh. How's the gutter doing?
Crack rack.
All right, all right.
Might be, best favorite or best Frank Ocean songs of all time.
The fuck! I was just gonna say that. Just had to steal the line from me.
Well,
this is one of the best songs ever made, period, in my opinion.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it's a fucking accomplishment.
Oh, this.
Dog.
I don't think I've listened to the entire thing.
Oh god, dude, you're in for a fucking ride.
You haven't heard like the last part of that song?
No.
Ooh.
No more, no more, Nadia.
Okay, okay, sorry.
Oh my god. I've probably listened to this like 800,000 times, but I still love it. Like, I never get tired of it.
The whole way through, too.
Yeah.
We'll run to the future, shining like diamonds.
Fuck, man.
I keep blood, our skin like bronze, our hair like cashmere, as we march to the rhythm on the palace floor.
Oh my god, this guy, dude.
What good is a jewel that ain't still precious? How could you run off on me? How could you run off on us? You feel like
you both have your eyes closed.
Yeah.
Find your lady down, Samson. And his full head of hair.
Why aren't you closing your eyes now?
I get it. No, I get it. I just.
I'm trying so, so hard not to, like, hum or sing along. This is so fucking... The melody is like, ugh! Oh. Okay, ready? Ready, motherfuckers?
No.
I'm never ready for this, and I'm always like,
oh, I can see my milky white thighs. come back.
Even that is.
All right, everyone shut the fuck up.
Big sun coming strong through the motel blinds. Wake up to your girl. For now, let's call her Cleopatra. Cleopatra. I'll watch you fix your hair and put your panties on in the mirror. Cleopatra. Then your lipstick. Cleopatra. In your 6-inch heels catcher. She's headed to the pyramid. She's working at the pyramid tonight. Working at the pyramid. Working at the pyramid tonight. Yeah. Working at the pyramid. Working at the pyramid tonight. Yeah. Working at the pyramid.
This kind of music making brings fucking tears to my eyes.
Pimping in my convo. Bubbles in my champagne. Let it be some jazz playing. Top floor motel suite. Twisting my cigars. Floor model TV with the VCR. Got rubies in my damn chain. Whip ain't got no gas tank, but it still got wood grain. Got your girl working.
Yeah, like, let me just do that to the lyric. Hit the strip
in my bill. Oh, his bills are fucking paid, man.
Bruh.
Hit the strip in my bills pay.
Keep a nigga bills pay. That trumpet or whatever. So beautiful.
Why does it feel like you're tripping on LSD?
That's the fucking idea,
I've never done LSD, but like...
That's Frank. Let's go, man. Now you're understanding. I love that fucking effect right there on that one. On that line. Ready? We're not done.
Dude, whoa!
This whole verse, too. Like, the lyrics.
This is probably the horniest Frank's ever been on a song.
Dude.
Yo, okay.
Wait. Okay, go ahead, dude.
Is there a Frank Ocean album with like a rainbow or like psychedelic colors on it?
Yeah, Endless.
Okay, that's what this feels like.
Yeah.
I'm visualizing like
tripping.
Purples, blues, pinks.
Yeah. Colors. Yeah, I feel you. Yeah, but Endless is like, it's like an iridescent, like kind of reflective. Yeah.
That's exactly what it is to me.
Yeah.
This is one of my favorite like
outros of all time.
Inch hands fucking down.
Oh, it's so fucking just like yeah. I love when a guitar sings. Sorry, go ahead.
I have to say, that was the fast 9 minutes.
Yeah, I know, it flies by, eh?
Because
it's
perfect, and it's supposed to be 9 minutes.
Ah! What I love about this album, I'll say this real quick. Most of Frank's music I associate to somebody, and it's usually in kind of like a sad way. But Channel Orange is just pure fucking vibes, man. Speaking of pure fucking vibes.
This is a pure fucking vibe, bro.
Oh, fuck
bro,
yeah,
this
it is.
Fucking song. This song. Big full breast on my baby. Triple A,
couldn't wait the love I got for the girl. Oh my god. He can't take care of you like this.
Now you're lost. I'm trying so hard not to sing to it.
I get it, man.
It's hard as fuck.
Oh, you want to do it? No, have I ever let you get caught? Lost in the heat of it all. Girl, you know you lost. My God. If it wasn't raining and cold, I'd be fucking windows down.
I know.
Going for a drive immediately right out.
I was literally about to say, this brings me back to like in the summer, driving in Toronto with the fucking sun, windows down. Oh, man.
This song gives me that smell of summer.
Yeah.
At night after it rained during the day, and you can just smell the freshness.
Yeah, dude.
Oh. I love that we all get the same vibes. Miami,
Amsterdam, Tokyo. I love this part right here.
How do you even come up with such a freaking funky little melody?
It's Frank fucking Ocean, motherfucker. I don't care. I'll be the first to admit it. I fucking glaze him so hard. I don't give a shit, man.
No matter what happens.
No, seriously.
So real, Koof.
John Mayer's on this, hey, Koof?
Hmm?
John Mayer's on this. Guitar. Yeah, yeah.
I can't.
Oh, yeah.
This would be such a good song to fuck to.
Hell yeah, dude.
Bruh.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
I had to do this because it
touched
to be
my
sexual.
Boy.
You had to whisper it into boy, the fucking dude. Mic.
Hell yeah.
Oh, man.
That better stay in the video.
Oh, I'm not cutting that.
Hell yeah.
Monks.
Minks?
Minks? Perhaps?
Mosh pits and beer chests. Stage diver, skydiver. Spray the crowd with cold water. Now it's mosh pits and wet tits. I think I need a cold shower. Cool water. African girl speaks an English accent. Likes to fuck boys and bands. Likes to watch westerns. And ride me without the hand.
Oh, yeah.
Show me her passport. She's on her own tour. But you're beautiful to me. Ooh. Wave them high, girl. To the sky. But you're beautiful to me.
Cool.
Wave them high. Monks in the mosh pit. Stage diving Dalai Lama. Covered in cut flowers. They mosh for enlightenment.
Clean. I just had imagery of monkeys in a mosh pit.
Monks in a mosh pit, bud.
I know.
Young and hard. You found a boyfriend and now you wanna get away. Get away. Just a virgin. I wanna get away. Get away.
Wait, wait.
And that sunset that gonna try and get away.
This is serious.
I've heard me drop. I never asked for much. But please keep up a lover. We've got no choices left.
Yo, let's go.
Run is fast. Run. You're beautiful to me. My world. We made it safe. Even with your father's army trailing us, we escaped him. Even with his archers bows at our backs. What a great escape. But there's a long way still, in fact.
Oh.
Lost in the jungle underneath these clouds.
This song slaps so fucking hard.
Sure fucking does, man.
And it's not just because of the mosh pitting monkeys.
A coke white tiger woke us from our slumber.
to guide and protect us to the end. Now shut the fuck up and listen to this.
Let me guess, you guys are foot tapping?
Oh, I'm like smacking my knees like this.
My ass is jumping up and down from the chair.
God, you guys are so fucking geriatric.
Whatever, at least we're having fun. Now we're sad again. Are we doing that?
Add religion.
No, this song's actually sad as fuck.
I think I know this one.
But it's so good.
Yeah, I know this one.
Be my shrink for the hour. Leave the meter running. It's rush hour. So take the streets if you want. Just outrun the demons.
Damn, I should have worn my Bad Religion shirt.
He said, Allahu Akbar. I told him don't curse me.
Does it have a cross on it?
I guess it couldn't hurt.
No.
If it brings me to my knees, it's a bad religion. Ooh, it's unrequited love. To me, it's nothing but one man calls. Inside and out of my style.
Like, okay, Tone.
I can never make them love me. Never make them love, love, love.
God damn it.
Akbar, I told him don't curse me. But boy, you need prayer. I guess they couldn't hurt me.
Oh my God.
If it brings me to my knees. It's a bad religion. Oh, unrequited love.
Ooh.
To me it's nothing. No, no. Oh, it's a bad religion. To be in love with someone who can never love you. Oh, oh, oh. Only bad religion.
Hmm.
Had me feeling the way I do.
So the next song I have on my likes, but I don't recall it at all.
Oh, okay.
You probably will.
I'm just pausing for a second just because I just quickly want to, I don't know if it like went over your head or you were listening to the lyrics, but that song, I think pretty much everybody knows this, that knows Frank Ocean, but it's like really cool because I guess he's talking about, like, you know, Frank's bi, right? So he's, I guess it's about him being in love with a guy and having like problems with religion because God, you know, he thinks that God won't love him. You can say, like, he says, like, he'll never love me, or I can never make him love me. It could be about this guy or like unrequited love with God, because he feels like God doesn't fuck with him because of that, or he won't accept him because of that. And it's like his struggle with like his identity and his religion, because he believes, but he's also like, I don't know what, where I stand or what my place is with God. So I think it's, I mean, that, maybe that was pretty obvious, but it's something like pretty serious and like interesting to me that he wrote about this. So anyway, yeah, that's it.
Oh yeah.
This is one of the most iconic Andre 3000 verses.
Mm-hmm.
And the peaches and the mangoes that you could sell for me.
I'd sell him peaches and mangoes.
My brain is made for, is it just a container for the mind? This great gray matter. Since it replied, what is your woman? Is she just a container for the child? That's all.
The way he writes on this song specifically is so fucking beautiful.
Candy, magical, oh. Close my eyes and fall.
Oh man.
Even that, just that line.
Yeah.
Sheesh.
What if the sky and the stars are for show? Majin Buu.
Yeah.
Dim the lights and fall into a you. My God, giving me pleasure.
Listen to this, man. You guys hearing this shit?
Mm-hmm.
Best part of this song right here.
Since you've been gone, I've been having withdrawals. You were such a habit to call. I ain't myself at all, had to tell myself no. She better with some fella with a regular job. I didn't want to get her involved. By then, Mr. Benjamin was sitting in awe. Hops into my car, drove far. Falls too close, and I remember my memories no sharp. But a knife, what a life anyway. I'm building y'all a clock, stop, what am I headway? She had the kind of body that would probably intimidate any of them that were unsouthern. Not me, cousin. If models are made for modeling, thick girls are made for cuddling. Switch worlds and we can huddle then. Who needs another friend? I need to hold your hand. You need no other man. We flee to other lands.
God damn.
You better be a good. For heaven's sake, go to hell.
So motherfucking good. Make a squat the motherfucking wood. Make a walk the motherfucking plank. Make a rob a motherfucking bank with no mask on and arrest a revolver.
Alright, oh. So.
You wanna pause?
Another one of my favorite songs. Oh, no. I was just gonna say this is another one of my like favorite songs of all time. I know it's a lot of people's favorite from this album, or like
top for
a lot of people.
It's over my head.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like one of the more like listened to songs.
Yeah, for sure.
But I always say about this song that this just exemplifies what it like if you've ever been in love with a man.
Well, I haven't.
What it's like and what it sounds like.
What the fuck?
But also what it's like to be in love with a woman. But just the way he talks about whichever guy he's referring to is like just so relatable.
He said that his first love was a man. So this is like supposed to be about that.
Can we just like step back for a second? I wouldn't even ever been in love with a man and I'm sitting right here.
Oh shit.
That's your boy, dude.
Well,
okay, let's get into
I guess
this
the secret's out gorgeous, anyway. So. Whoa.
Oh shit.
Wanna see pom-poms from the stairs.
Yep.
Come on.
Yep.
My fingertips and my lips, they burn from the cigarettes. Forrest Gump, you run my mind, boy.
Yep.
Running on my mind, boy. Forrest Gump. I know you wouldn't hurt a beetle, but you're so buff and so strong.
Just that, those two lines.
Yeah.
I'm nervous, Forrest.
It's cool because this song is so like soft, even down to like the instrumental is very soft and like
from the cigarette.
It's, I don't know, it's like a, because he's talking about masculinity and how he's like obviously in love with that, but it's like cutesy, you know?
Yeah, because he's in love. It's just so clearly so in love with whoever this was.
I'm remembering you. This is love. I know it's true.
This part.
So youthful and sweet and innocent.
I know. This has an outro too.
Yep.
It's so soothing.
I love that last little wah, wah, wah.
I love the way this song sounds.
Mm-hmm. This is actually a song from before on one of the unreleased called Voodoo. Mm-hmm. And he kind of like brought it
back.
Oh,
yeah. She didn't compromise. She could recognize. Our daughters and our sons are just candles in the sun.
Isn't this an interesting sound, though?
The rain.
He's, like, not really present.
Yeah.
It's, like, fading away, but you hear the rain, and it sounds like it's ending and starting to go away.
Damn, bro, that delivery right there.
And then just it like comes in. It's so crazy.
Mm-hmm. The ambiance and stuff that Frank always kind of throws into his albums.
Beautiful stuff.
Yep.
Nice.
That's Channel Orange, baby.
Whoa.
And it's like you were in the car the whole time with him.
Yeah. It's like then he just went inside and he was like, good night.
Good night, Franklin.
Yeah.
Love you. Deeply.
I want to know what you think, Cooper.
Obviously, I loved it.
Okay, yeah. Good.
There's really nothing to say. It's just an outstanding piece of work.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess you pretty much said everything.
That makes my heart
smile. Yeah.
It's one of those albums that will always be important to me and just like super nostalgic and it's got some of the best music ever in my opinion. I just want to note though, we had a lot of fun, you know, during like the first kind of just slows down towards the end of the album, but we were having a lot of fun and really happy and upbeat, and it's like such a good vibe. Just wait till we listen to Blonde, bro, or even Endless.
I know Blonde, dude.
No, I know, but
bro, I'm like, no!
it's not the same fucking
all of us
vibe
together.
Yeah. Shit, yeah. So
so true.
I think,
bro, it's like when we get on Godspeed, I'm just gonna be like fucking
no.
I think the way we're gonna go is after this, the next Frank thing we'll do will be Nostalgia Ultra, so we'll get like kind of the older stuff out of the way, and then we'll do Endless, Blonde, Singles, so we'll go like in that order.
Oh fuck, I can't wait for Singles. It's gonna
me
be good.
Too nice. Yeah, any thoughts, anything you want to add before we go here? I know we kind of like talked a lot about it while it was going, but anything
a true dream of mine is to get, I don't think this is ever going to happen, but an official like pressing of this album.
Oh yeah.
Just because like it's always been an album I just can like have on in the back and just like vibe to, and the sounds are so like calming and pretty. So that's the kind of shit I love to have in my collection, but I don't know if we'll ever get that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Have Wand, so that's pretty sick. But
I have Endless, which you don't have.
So not fair at all. But
my
yeah.
prized possession. But yeah, yeah, I'm glad that we did that. It was really cool to sit down and like dedicate a session to like just completely taking the album in with you guys and enjoying it together. That's the whole fucking point of this, right? Like, even if it's stuff we kind of know, it's still, it's like doing this is like, it makes albums for me, even if I already know them, like even more fun and entertaining and mean more. So yeah.
Yeah.
All right. All right, guys. So that was our reaction to Channel Orange by Frank Ocean. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let us know if there's anything else you want us to react to, because we'll definitely consider it. And like we said, we will be doing all of the other Frank Ocean stuff. But if there's anything, you know, his contemporaries or anything that reminds you of him or anything else at all, just let us know. And we'll definitely consider it. But yeah, that's us. And we'll see you guys in the next one.
Peace.
We put out the feathers for this type of weather. She put her to club to bust up a dub. She came with a man, I called in the sub. She giving her hugs, we know about the mud. She put in my hand, don't know what it was. She knows I'm the fan. But-